God is kind. God is patient. God is long-suffering. You know? God does not rejoice in iniquity. He does not rejoice in evil. He does not rejoice in misfortune. And I was sharing this to the Bible school students. Never use anybody's misfortune as a testimony. Never. Say, praise the Lord. We were traveling and traveling. Then suddenly, our car developed fault. As soon as it developed fault, another car overtook us. And they landed in the hands of armed robbers. 18 of them dead. I would have been the one dead. But God saved me and gave 18 people for my life. What you're saying is that God is an evil God. Don't use somebody's misfortune as a testimony. No, don't do that. That's not God. In the New Testament, it has been proven that God delivered people without killing. So if Jesus was there when David killed Goliath, he would have rebuked David. Because he could have delivered Israel from the Philistines without killing anybody. Peter is in prison. An angel enters, brings Peter out without hurting anybody. When the man wants to harm himself, they said to him, do yourself no harm, we're here. If you want to take us back, take us back. But if it is to harm you, you don't have to harm yourself. And if you take us back, the same way we came out, we'll come out again. That God can deliver without harming anybody. Am I talking to somebody here? That is God's character. God doesn't have to kill somebody for you to succeed. God doesn't have to pull somebody down for you to climb up. No, all of us can climb up at the same time. The world is big enough to occupy us. I feel like I'm preaching here. God is a good God. He giveth us all things richly, all of us. Nobody has to be down for you to be up. Amen.